Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. At this stage, we should have a new project, and we have now modularized our settings file. So let's talk a little bit about the Django secret key. Back into our settings base file here, you probably already noticed there is a secret key variable, and it has a very long string. So after Django in secure, it should be a 50 character long string. So noticed that by default, Django has created a key for us. Now, this key can be any length from one character, and it's always recommended that you utilize a long string. So that adds to the security of your secret key. The basics here is that we need to remember that a secret key must be unique for every single Django application, and it's used for providing cryptographic signing. At this point, cryptographic signing is a little bit out of scope of this project. All we need to know at this point is the secret key is important to keep secret. So we need to, one, have a way of keeping it a secret, and we'll learn about that in the next tutorials. And secondly, we want to know how to create a secret key. Now, you can go ahead and just type in whatever you like. Of course you could. But Django does provide a tool and for us to actually generate a secret key that we can use. The Python standard library does provide the tools for us to actually build a random secret key, but we will use the Django tools, which will ultimately use those Python tools anyway, but we'll utilize the Django tools to generate this key. Hopefully I haven't made that sound too complicated, but let's go into Python 3, manage.py, and then we'll go into a shell. So we'll create a shell wrapped around Django so we can access Django tools. And from here, we'll type in from, and then inside of Django core, dot management dot utils. Let's go ahead and import the get random secret. So secret key. Okay, so that's going to bring in a resource here into the console. So I can go ahead and just type in print get random secret key. And there we go. Notice that it returns a function. So you will need to use the parentheses at the end here, and then that will generate a secret key. So let's go ahead and copy that in to our secret key. And there we go. Like I said previously, we will want to protect our secret key. And one way we can do that is by utilizing environment variables. So next up, we're going to learn a little bit about environment variables, how to configure them within our project initially, so that we can start to think about protecting some of this sensitive information. So for example, the secret key, eventually we're going to have information regarding, for example, our database username and password. So we want to protect that too. So let's move on now to configuring environment variables.